It has been established that persons who have recently died have been returning to life and committing acts of murder.
Hello, everybody. I want to talk to you about a movie that I love. It's called Near Dark. It's a vampire movie that was released in 1987. It was released the same year as The Lost Boys, coincidentally. And The Lost Boys is a lot more well-received and known. And this film kind of falls under the radar a little bit. And I think it's because of that.
Personally, I don't think I like one better than the other. The Lost Boys is something I grew up with. It kind of, to me, seems more of a nostalgia thing. But it's also really good either way. But Near Dark was something I found a little later on in my life. I probably saw it about 6 years ago on cable.
It was directed by Kathryn Bigelow, who went on to do things like Zero Dark Thirty, The Hurt Locker. She did Point Break.
It was shot by Adam Greenberg, who shot Terminator, and a bunch of other things, but I know he shot Terminator, and he is a very, very impressive cinematographer. This movie has lots of blue tones, and, you know, it's like something you really feel when you see the images. They're just, the colors there, they just really make you, I don't know, sort of immerse yourself in watching it.
But it's really, really well made, and beautiful soundtrack by Tangerine Dream that really sets the tone for the movie. The movie takes place in a small rural town near Oklahoma or Texas, I believe. The main protagonist is a young man named Caleb, who lives at home still. I'm not sure if he's supposed to be in high school or he's just living at home. It doesn't seem like he has much figured out in his life at the point we meet him in the movie. One night, he goes out with his friends, I believe, and they all see this beautiful woman around their age, of course, and they kind of all jokingly talk about going over and talking to her, and Caleb's the one that musters up the courage to go over there. Well, you know, long story short, she's a fucking vampire and bites him on the neck, which... Then he soon discovers that he can't be in the sunlight without catching on fire or starting to smoke. So what happens is he gets kidnapped by a traveling group of vampires. The casting in this film is really, really awesome. I believe Kathryn Bigelow was involved romantically or something with James Cameron, so she got a lot of the people that worked with him on Aliens in this. Caleb Colton is played by Adrian Pasdar. Jenny Wright is May. Lance Henriksen is awesome. He's sort of the leader of the pack. His name's Jesse Hooker in the movie. Jenette Goldstein's sort of like the wife of Jesse Hooker. And she's really good in it too. There's a kid in it. He's like probably like 12 or 13. His name's Homer. And Joshua Miller plays him. You know, he's good in it too. Everybody in this movie is really good. But hands down, the best performance is Bill Paxton as Severin. And he is sort of a Wild West shoot 'em up type of guy that is now a vampire or has been a vampire for who knows how long. And let me tell you, he is just unhinged in this film. I mean, he makes the whole thing very entertaining. There's a scene where they all go to a bar, and you know, they're kind of trying to get Caleb to become like them, you know, kill in the night, and he doesn't want to kill, and he kind of doesn't believe what's happening and these things, and he tries to go home, and it just never works out for him. He doesn't really accept what he is, so they kind of coax him into trying to be like them, which is, you know, a creature of the night, and he must feast on blood. So they take him to this bar, and it's so clear this was like a Western, you know. I mean, they walk in, and there's all these kind of hicks looking at them, and, you know, they're all getting antsy because they want to eat, you know, they want to feast on blood. And between Lance Hendrickson's performance sort of being in this sort of, you know, do what I tell you to or I'll fucking kill you attitude, and Bill Paxton's wild Bill having fun at the bar, you know, it's really a tense scene and makes the whole film creepier, I would say, you know, and not just so this or that. It's a creepy film because of the scene. Unreal stuff. Can't really even, you know, recommend this film enough. It's such a wonderful thing to watch if you're into, you know, horror films and vampire stuff. And it's so underrated is what I really want to talk about. I feel like a lot of people don't know about this movie, and, you know, it gets kind of thrown away as just some crap that no one knows about and this stuff. But if you really liked Bill Paxton and you like Lance Hendrickson, this film is really for you. I mean,
so, you know, it's just got a lot of things going for it that are made well. You know, the way it was shot, the music, the acting.
So maybe vampires aren't your thing. Twilight kind of tainted everybody's idea of what a vampire movie is supposed to be and played into this sort of teeny bopper mentality. And I think, although in the 80s, like this film and Lost Boys played into teen subculture as like part of the element of the cool vampire myth, you know, this movie doesn't give you that shitty bad taste in your mouth that you would get from watching something like Twilight.
I won't spoil much else for the movie. The scene you just watched, if that doesn't sell you, I don't know what will.
The film seems to be commenting on, you know, the AIDS epidemic at the time, I would say. And also, you know, drug abuse and things like that. But the movie ultimately doesn't, you know, try to come off too preachy or something. And it still stays in this sort of fun light, even though it has a very serious tone, and thematically it's pretty, like, you know, serious, but it's still fun, and that's, again, something I think that's lacking in a lot of movies today.
In 1996, Robert Rodriguez made From Dusk Till Dawn, when very much seemed to be a Western vampire film. In 1998, just a few years after that, John Carpenter released Vampires, featuring James Woods as a lead. And it takes place in the desert, and it's kind of like a Western. In 2001, there was another movie called The Forsaken that was a mixture of a Western and a vampire film. It seems as though it just kind of fit and made sense, but Near Dark was undoubtedly the first to do it. I find that really what's missing
today more than anything is just pure fun and a whole lot of originality. On that note, I'm going to let you guys go. I would really appreciate it if you guys subscribed and, you know, like my videos and things like that. And we'll continue maybe to do these reviews. I appreciate it. Thanks a lot.